the Bern Symposium on Global Cybersecurity Awareness Messaging that was held on 1st and 2nd September in Switzerland. Now, the reason why I put up this report, or the reason why Mr. Remy has asked me to do this presentation, is so that we can be abreast of what was discussed at the symposium and see what we can learn. So what I've simply done is I have I picked highlights from various presentations at the conference and then put it into a PowerPoint slide so that we can all learn. The symposium was attended by 43 participants from about 38 organizations from different parts of the world, including Australia Post, APG, both in the US and APG EU. We even had presentation from Commonwealth, ENISA, all of them, Indiana University, all of these, United Nations and the rest. People from all these organizations, most of them actually made presentation on what they've been doing on cybersecurity awareness in their organizations and even in their country. If you can see, there are some SATs, Computer Emergency Response Team, that actually came to make presentation. Session was there. Actually, Session was represented by Mr. Remy, Mr. Ade, and myself. Three of us represented Session. Okay. This presentation was made by Eric Freisnet, the Secretary General, CIFI. He itemized three action tracks that they are using in their organization. And he said it's prevention, training, research, and development. Under training, they have under prevention, they have prevention campaigns that they actually did with PayPal and Signalspan in 2010 and 2014. They have antibots with Signalspan also, and prevention action towards future students of training. They actually launched Cypher Training and Prevention Label. That's the website. Actually, this presentation will be circulated. So if you want to have a look at this website to see what they are doing much later, you can feel free to do that. They have organization of meetings on training needs and research and development. They are researching into several stuff like support funding for cybersecurity projects and R&D needs generally, and they are doing well on it. Okay, this presentation was by Head of Innovation and Culture, Information Security Office in Australia. Actually, the Australia Post. And she came, her name is Simone. She came out from a point of, not a technical person now. She came out from a point of an ordinary, you know, not really in the cybersecurity field, and saying, how best can we make people understand this cybersecurity awareness we are talking about? Beyond, okay, now they have an organization, or they have a group that they call Security Influence and Trust. That's the group. And basically, their mission is to advance the security awareness function across Australia through sharing, connecting, and leading. So basically, she now itemized, she said the current state of awareness, what we have now is, for the consumer, we say, use antivirus software, use strong password, change password frequently. For cybersecurity, we say, keep the operating system and application up to date, use multi-factor. For her, she said, these things are a bit complicated for the normal man out there. That it's time for us to make impacts in cyber, impacts to change cybercrime. Then we have to calm down and have things like don't forget the victim. Before coming out with awareness strategy, we have to look at antecedents, behaviors, and consequences. Now, if you come to people and not just saying change password, but if you say, oh, change your password like this, if you don't, this is what you get. That way, people would feel the impact of what you're saying better. And then she actually stressed that we should take advantage of cultural awareness, permission, and affirmation. Those things are already permitted in the culture to now use to propagate this cybersecurity awareness capacity confidence, tools, and practices. Now, Kerry Ann and Barrett, she's actually from Organization of American States. She actually made this presentation. The presentation was quite interesting, so I had a couple of slides from it. Now, basically, they are into development of national cybersecurity strategy, technical training, workshops, country-specific technical missions, cybersecurity exercises, development of national computer cybersecurity emergency response teams, and the rest. The awareness is into, they're doing raising research and expertise. Now, other reason, she said they raise cybersecurity awareness through multi-stakeholders outreach. They actually do outreach. They produce research and data focused on cybersecurity in Latin America and Caribbean regions. They develop expertise in the area of cybersecurity from Latin America and Caribbean region. And basically, their cybersecurity awareness campaign focuses on risk management, understanding shared responsibilities, and their audience are basically government, private sector, and individual citizens. Now, she drew this path to awareness raising. She said, first of all, before you carry out awareness, there are basics. You need to identify your stakeholders, get people's attention, welcome them into the conversation. Once you identify them, you need to find a way of bringing them in on what your campaign will be about. Inform them of the risk frequently and with unified messaging. Now, unified messaging here is, as a group, wherever it is, cybersecurity awareness everywhere, which is actually what Stop Think Connect is promoting, is we should have one message. If it's used 8Password, let's use 8Password. If it's used, not some people say 8Password, some people say 16Password, it's confusing people. People need to come to a point where the message is one, stay safe, as simple and... So she said in designing campaign, one, the awareness and education continuum, the campaign structure, the message, and the campaign plan has to be put in place, not just waking up and going out to do campaign. We need to strategize.